In 1990, fossil collectors in South Dakota stumbled across a dinosaur that turned out to be a really big deal. Not just because it was a T-Rex, basically the most popular dino out there, or because it ended up in Chicago's famous Field Museum, but because of the number of bones it had. Hi, I'm Kate, and this is Minute Earth. The dino, now named Sue, was such a big deal because of how complete it was. The fossilized skeleton had 250 of the 380 or so bones that had once made up the living dino, which might not seem like that much, but the vast majority of dinosaur fossils we find are just a few bone fragments or a single tooth. We don't tend to find complete specimens because while becoming a fossil is pretty unlikely in the first place, the fossilization of an entire skeleton is even more unlikely. When prehistoric critters like dinos died, their bodies would get torn apart by predators and scavengers. Their bones would get scattered by flowing water, trampled by herds of animals, and weathered by the sun and wind. So most skeletons got broken up before they even had a chance to fossilize. Only occasionally would skeletons escape all this wear and tear and get buried completely, or even mostly, intact. And when they did, they were often in places without the right chemistry for fossilization, so they just decomposed. Any skeletons that did fossilize still had to make it through tens of millions of years of geological upheaval that shuffled up entire layers of rocks. Even if a skeleton made it complete through all that, it still has to be discovered at the perfect moment in order to stay complete. When there's been enough erosion to expose the fossil, but not enough to weather away big parts of the fossil itself. So even mostly complete skeletons like Sue's are really, really rare. But there are a few conditions that can protect a dinosaur's skeleton from being lost to time. Like when a dino was killed and buried at the same time. In, say, a volcanic eruption, or a torrent of mud that scientists call a debris flow. Because these skeletons got buried right away, they have a much better shot at staying intact than skeletons that just lay around for a while. Second, since smaller dinos required a lot less sediment to bury, they were more likely to get covered up, and therefore to end up complete. Finally, more common dinos, like the herbivorous Mosasaurus, simply left behind more skeletons than rarer dinos did. So it's more likely that they would make it through the fossilization gauntlet whole. Sue was a T-Rex, a relatively large, relatively uncommon dino, therefore a relatively unlikely candidate to end up so complete. But it happened anyway, probably thanks to a giant debris flow, which is lucky for us, because not only is the fossil amazing to look at, its completeness has taught us lots about the anatomy, biomechanics, and even daily life of a T-Rex. But then again, the fact that a series of very unusual events was required to preserve that skeleton so well means that Sue isn't particularly representative of how most dinos died, or the conditions that normally scattered and weathered their bodies. To learn about those things, we have to study those more common, less complete fossils. So while finding Sue was amazing, you might say that finding any dino fossil, no matter how complete, is pretty superb.